Dear students, we have discussed the COIAC approach to distributed log model in the last class. And we have seen how an infinite distributed log model is converted into a finite model, an autoregressive model, with just three coefficients to estimate. But the model, even though it is mathematically very elegant, has one limitation. The limitation is the model is obtained purely by mathematical manipulation. There is no theory behind this procedure. Stated differently, COIAC distributed log model is devoid of any theoretical underpinning. Now, we consider cases in which how we can give a theoretical basis to the COIAC approach. We consider two cases. The first we discuss in this class is the adaptive expectations model. It is a rationalization of the COIAC model. It is known as adaptive expectations model. Popularized by Friedman and Kagan. Popularized by Friedman and Kagan. To explain this model, let us consider a model like this. Yt summum beta 0 plus beta 1 x star t plus ut. Yt is equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 x star t plus ut, where y is demand for money or demand for real cash balances, demand for money, and x star is expected long run equilibrium rate of interest. X star is expected long run equilibrium or optimal rate of interest. Expected long run equilibrium or optimal rate of interest. So this model says that demand for money or demand for real cash balances is a function of expected long run optimum or equilibrium rate of interest. So x star t. That is, demand for money is not a function of actual rate of interest. It is a function of expected rate of interest. Now we know that expected variables are x and a variables. X and a. Expected variables are x and a variables as against exposed variables, and as such they are not observable. We know that variables are classified into x and a and exposed. Exposed means realized. What is observed? X and a means expected. So expected variables are not observable. So we cannot estimate this model as such, as data on X star is not available. So to measure such expectational variables, we must find a way to substitute expectational variables. We have to find out a way to substitute expectational variables. And this is possible if and only if we suggest a method in which how expectations are formulated. To estimate this model, we have to substitute this expected variable. To substitute this expected variable, we have to make assumptions about how expectations are formulated. Now, we assume that expectations are formulated by a principle known as X star T minus X star T minus 1 is equal to, we formulate a hypothesis regarding how expectations are formulated. The hypothesis is given in the form of an equation, xt minus x star t minus 1. We assume that expectations are formulated by a hypothesis given by the equation x star t minus x star t minus 1 is gamma of xt minus x star t minus 1, where gamma is such that it is between 0 and 1. This equation is, gamma is known as the coefficient of expectations. And this equation is known as adaptive expectations hypothesis, progressive expectations hypothesis, or error learning hypothesis. This hypothesis, this equation, hypothesis represented in the form of an equation is known as adaptive expectations hypothesis, error learning hypothesis, or what is known as progressive expectations hypothesis, popularized by Friedman and Kagel. Gamma is known as the coefficient of expectations. Now let us see what is the meaning of this equation, this error learning hypothesis. The interpretation is that economic agents will adapt their expectations in the light of past experience. Economic agents will adapt their expectations in the light of past experience, and that in particular they will learn from their mistakes. Adaptive expectations hypothesis says that economic agents will adapt their expectations on the basis of past experience. In particular, they will learn from past mistakes. Now, what this equation says is that expectations are revised each period by a fraction gamma of the discrepancy between the expected value of the variable, expectations are revised each period by a fraction gamma of the gap between current value of that variable and its previous expected value. What this equation means is expectations are revised by a fraction gamma of the gap between current value of the variable, that is the current interest rate, and its previous expected value. Suppose that this is year 2020, and this is year 2019. So XT is the actual interest rate in 2020. X star T minus 1 is the expected value of interest rate for the year 2020 expected in the year 2019. If the expected interest rate was say 8%, actually is 10%, a discrepancy of 2% is observed. So economic agents will adapt their expectations by a fraction gamma. So if gamma is equal to 0.5, that is 0.5 of 2% equal to 1%. They will adapt their expectations by 1%. That is a fraction of the gap between the actual value of the variable and its previous expected value. In our example, expectations about interest rates are revised by a fraction gamma of the discrepancy between the rate of interest observed in the current period and what its anticipated value had been in the previous period. Expectations are revised by a fraction gamma of the current interest rate and its previous expected value to exist for the year, say, 2020. Adapt the expectation only, a fraction of the discrepancy will be adapted. If gamma, because coefficient of expectations lie between 0 and 1. Now this can be written as X star T is equal to X star T minus 1, this quantity is the plus gamma XT minus X star T minus 1 X star T is equal to gamma XT first plus 1 minus gamma X star T minus 1. X star T is equal to gamma XT plus 1 minus gamma X star T minus 1. In this formulation, it says that expected value of the rate of interest is a weighted average of actual value of the interest rate at T, that is expected value of interest rate at T. X star T is a weighted average of actual value of the interest rate at T and what was its previous expected value for the year T. The weights are gamma and 1 minus gamma. If gamma is equal to 1, you will see that X star T is equal to XT. That is, expectations will be realized fully. Expectations will be realized fully in the same year if gamma is equal to 1. If gamma is equal to 0, as you can see, X star T is equal to X star T minus 1. That is, the current status quo will be maintained. Expectations will not be revised year after year. The status quo will be maintained. Typically, gamma lie between these two extremes. Now this is, always remember this equation, and you are familiar with this equation in your course in macroeconomics. Adaptive expectations hypothesis of this form is extensively used in the context of Phillips curve analysis, augmented Phillips curve. This is also used in the context of permanent income hypothesis. Permanent income hypothesis we will discuss later. If you go through any books on macroeconomics, you will see that adaptive expectations hypothesis is used in the Pillsker analysis. As it is known to you, in the short run, Phillips curve is downward sloping. There is trade-off between inflation and unemployment. But in the longer run, there is no such trade-off. This is because economic agents formulate expectations using this principle. They revise their expectations by a fraction gamma of the discrepancy observed only. If economic agents are characterized by rational expectations, a new hypothesis introduced by followers of new classical school, there is no trade-off between inflation and unemployment. Phillips curve will be vertical. These are things which are known to you. Similarly, we will see how this rational expectations hypothesis is used in the context of permanent income hypothesis by Milton Friedman. That we will see in the next class. As a specific example. So this mechanism is very important. It must be remembered forever. This mechanism is known as adaptive expectations hypothesis, error learning hypothesis, progressive expectations hypothesis, etc. Now, substitute the value of x star t in this equation. Y t is equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 gamma xt plus 1 minus gamma x star t minus 1 plus ut gamma xt plus 1 minus gamma x star t minus 1 plus ut. Then we go through a little mathematical manipulation. So yt is equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 gamma xt plus beta 1 1 minus gamma x star t minus 1 plus ut. And since this is yt, yt minus 1 is equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 x star t minus 1 plus ut minus 1, and multiply this with 1 minus gamma. 1 minus gamma y t minus 1 is equal to 1 minus gamma beta 0 plus 1 minus gamma beta 1 x star t minus 1 plus 1 minus gamma ut minus 1. So we have one minus gamma as equal to yt minus 1. Now yt minus 1 minus gamma yt minus 1 is equal to, consider yt minus 1 minus gamma yt minus 1 is equal to beta 0 minus 1 minus gamma beta 0 is equal to beta 0. Beta 0 minus, beta 0 minus 1 minus gamma beta 0 is equal to gamma beta 0. Beta 0 minus 1 minus gamma beta 0 is equal to gamma beta 0 plus, this term is absent here, so beta 1 gamma xt, beta 1 gamma xt plus, as you can see, this term and this term will be cancelled, plus ut minus 1 minus gamma ut minus 1, and can be written as yt is equal to gamma beta 0 plus beta 1 gamma xt plus 1 minus gamma yt minus 1 plus ut minus 1 minus gamma ut minus 1 is written as vt. So we have the equation. We have the equation. Now, yt now depends on xt, yt minus 1. And vt is a moving average of ut and ut minus 1. And in appearance, this equation look like the Koyak model. The Koyak model also yt depends on xt and yt minus 1. Even though the interpretation of coefficients are different. In the Koyak model, yt was equal to alpha into 1 minus lambda plus beta 0 xt plus lambda yt minus 1 plus say epsilon. Coefficients are different, interpretation is also different. Otherwise, if you regress y on x and yt minus 1, you will get an equation similar in appearance to the Koyak model. Now, if you compare this equation, let me say that this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. If you compare equations 1 and 2, equations 1 and 2, it is clear that this is the longer run demand for money. Longer run demand for money, because the beta 1 measures the average change in the demand for money for a 1 unit change in the longer run expected rate of interest. Expected rate of interest. And in this model, what is beta 1 gamma, the coefficient of xt, measures the average change in the demand for money for a 1 unit change in the actual interest rates. Beta 1 gamma measures average response of y to a unit change in actual y. So we can interpret 1 as longer run demand for money and 2 as short run demand for money. Longer run demand for money and short run demand for money. And these two are not same. These two will be same if and only if gamma is equal to 1. If gamma is equal to 1, 1 minus 1, 0, this term disappears. And also, it becomes beta 1, the same model. Same model means, gamma is equal to 1 means, expectations will not change. What is observed today will be maintained throughout. But this we do not expect. So, the responses will be different. So, what we do is, we estimate this model by regressing yt on xt and yt minus 1. The coefficient of yt minus 1 is, say, phi is equal to 1 minus gamma. Suppose that coefficient of yt minus 1 is 5, then it is then gamma is equal to, say, for example, 1 minus gamma. Gamma is equal to, 5 is equal to 1 minus gamma. So, gamma is equal to 1 minus 1. So, once we obtain the coefficient of yt minus 1, you will get gamma. Then, you divide this beta 1 gamma by this value gamma, you will get beta 1. Then gamma beta 0 by gamma beta 0. And we drop this term, you will get the long run demand for money. You will get beta 0 and beta 1. So what we do is, we estimate this model. And once this model is estimated, that is, we estimate the short run demand for money. And once the shorter demand for money is estimated, we derive the longer demand for money using this process. Now this is what is known as adaptive expectations hypothesis, and there is considerable controversy among macroeconomists regarding whether the adaptive expectations hypothesis is correct or rational expectations hypothesis is correct. So this controversy is going on. You can refer any standard book of macroeconomics to get more insight about rational expectations hypothesis and adaptive expectations hypothesis. It will be useful for getting more insights about how expectations are formed by economic agents. Now, this equation must be remembered. So this is one rationalization of Koeg model. And suppose that by using data, I estimate a consumption function like this, say C hat T is equal to 2.36 plus 0.29 XT plus 0.675 CT minus 1. That is, consumption is C, depends on income, and C minus 1. Now, this 1 minus gamma is 0.675, so that gamma is 1 minus 0.675 is equal to 0.32, and gamma beta 2 by gamma is equal to 0.29 divided by 0.32 is equal to 0.91. Dividing this also with gamma, you will get the long run consumption function as CT is equal to 7.27 plus 0.91 x star t, the long run consumption function. And as you can see, this is the impact multiplier. That is, the in the consumption function example, if income increases by 1 unit, the immediate response is MBC increases by 0.29. But if the increase is maintained, in the long run, MBC become 0.91. MBC become 0.91. If you add it together, all the multipliers, both the impact and interim multipliers, you will get the long run multiplier. So this is how we obtained. So, and this is adaptive expectations hypothesis. We specify a model like this, and by specifying how expectations are formulated by economic agents, so there is a theory behind this, a theory explaining how economic agents formulate their expectations. We estimate a short run function like this. This is the demand for money, and this is, if we specify consumption as a function of permanent income, then we estimate this. We estimate the short run consumption function, and from the short run consumption function, we derive the long run consumption function. If you want more examples, you refer any book on econometrics about how to implement the estimation procedure. Estimation is easy. You have y, you have x, take a log of y and simply estimate it. This is very easy in the softwares. And in the next class, we will explain the permanent income hypothesis as a special case of this adaptive expectations hypothesis introduced by Milton Friedman.